For taking blood sample for PRP or GFC, always ask the patient to lie down first, because when the patient is lying down, venous pooling of blood will happen. You will get a better, thicker vein. Then sit down on a comfortable stool before taking the sample, because when you are standing, your own shadow will obstruct the view. So we need around 15 to 20 ml of blood. So the patient and your own positioning are very important. Tie the tourniquet, ask the patient to tighten the fist, squeeze the fist, and then find a good thick vein. The vein should be a deeper vein, it should be straight. Don't take blood from a tortuous vein or a very superficial vein which looks thin. Then take the blood from right hand. Why? Because most of the patients are right-handed and so their muscles are more developed. You get a better vein on right hands. But yes, if you're not seeing a vein on the right hand, look for the other hand. You sometimes may find a better vein on the left side. So patient lying down, you sitting, find a good vein and then start. If you still are not able to find a good vein, ask the patient to exercise his hand a little. By exercise I mean tourniquet bandha rehna chahiye, fist tight rehna chahiye, and the patient can start flexing his biceps continuously. That will improve the blood circulation and you will be able to find a better vein for the sample. Now once your needle is in, slowly and steadily you take the sample. You don't pull too much, because sometimes the needle itself will come out. So 20 ml, once it's done, between 15 to 20 ml, you first ask the patient to open the fist, open the tourniquet, then take out the needle. A lot of people take out the needle first before the tourniquet and fist are open. So what happens is you end up with hematomas. So hematomas are very
dangerous. So you don't need to push the blood. You just put the needle in there, vacuum se apne aap ब्लड उसमें चला जाएगा. कुछ भी पुश नहीं करना है यहाँ पे. इट विल टेक जितना भी उसमें वैक्यूम है उस हिसाब से अपने आप उसमें आ जाता है. रफली 8 ml ऑफ ब्लड विल कम, बिकॉज दीज आर 8 ml वैक्यूटेनियस. सो अपने आप ब्लड विल कम इन ईच एंड एवरी ट्यूब. सपोज कभी होता है रेयरली कि कोई ट्यूब का वैक्यूम काम नहीं कर रहा है. एंड यस, डोंट ओपन द कैप, because I've had technicians and doctors who have opened the cap. If you open the cap, then वो vacuum खत्म हो जाएगा. Cap नहीं open करना है. Cap के through needle डाल के vacuum के से suck होगा वो blood. If by chance blood नहीं जा रहा है, vacuum proper नहीं है, then you can push, but try not to push, because when you push blood, platelets will break. So no pushing. Move the tubes like this. Don't shake rigorously, because again when you shake the tubes rigorously, platelets will break. So अपना purpose क्या है कि अच्छे से mix भी होना है, लेकिन बहुत ज़्यादा rigorously नहीं भी नहीं करना है. You have to tilt the tube up and down like this for 6 to 7 times. Done. Now you have to place it in the centrifuge. Opposite करके place करना है. आसपास करके नहीं. Why? Because वेट बैलेंस होना चाहिए. अगर आप वेट नहीं बैलेंस करोगे तो वो मेन थिंग ठीक से चलेगा नहीं. और ये सेंट्रीफ्यूज के अंदर ये छोटा सा ये रहता है, ये कभी कभी उल्टा हो जाता है, तो वो ध्यान से उसको लगा कर एंड ट्यूब्स को ऐसे, आई शो यू अगेन, वेट को बैलेंस करते हुए यू हैव टू प्लेस इट लाइक दिस ऑपोजिट में. सपोज अगर दो पेशेंट्स का एक साथ कर रहे हैं तो यू कैन डू इट. ऑलवेज लेबल देम. ट्यूब के ऊपर यहाँ पे यू कैन लेबल कौन से पेशेंट का क्या है एंड देन यू कैन प्लेस इट. अगर सपोज यू ओनली हैव वन ट्यूब, बिकॉज जैसे दिस इज डीएफसी, बट पीआरपी बनाने के सेकेंड राउंड में यू विल हैव ओनली वन ट्यूब. तो अगर आपने वन ट्यूब यहाँ डाली है तो वेट बैलेंस के लिए सेम ट्यूब में पानी, सिमिलर ट्यूब में पानी भर के you have to place it on the opposite side. तो हमेशा वेट बैलेंस करना है. वेट नहीं बैलेंस करेंगे तो सेंट्रीफ्यूज विल नॉट वर्क. उसके बाद यू हैव टू क्लोज द लिड. यू विल हियर अ टिक. स्विच इट ऑन. दिस शुड बी ऑन जीरो हमेशा. ये यहां से स्विच ऑन नहीं करना है हमेशा. यू हैव टू, अगर यहां है तो यू हैव टू ब्रिंग इट बैक. स्विच दिस ऑन. Once ये सेटल हो जाएगा उसके बाद यू हैव टू, दिस इज GFC, So 10 minutes, 3400 किधर आता है पीआरपी में, जैसे 1500 3500 तो किधर आता है रफली, सो दैट एकदम धीरे धीरे एकदम धीरे धीरे अगर आप करते हो तो बाय द टाइम यू रीच देयर एक डेढ़ मिनट आपका वेस्ट हो जाता है. तो वैसा नहीं, जहां तक आपको जाना है 3400 जैसे, तो अप्रोक्सीमेट वहां तक आपको पहले से ही याद रख के सेट कर लेना है. अभी 32 तक ही आया है, तो स्मॉल एडजस्टमेंट्स टिल इट रीचेस 34. 34 मतलब एकदम ऐसा लकीर का फकीर नहीं है, 10 हियर एंड देयर इज 5. That it stabilizes around 3400. Don't leave immediately. This now looks stable. So this is fine. Yeah, hota rahega. Patient ko yahan pe then put that round bandage. Put that. Then the way we give anesthesia, it varies. A lot of people give different tarike se log anesthesia dete hain for GFC PRP. बहुत सारे लोग एनेस्थीशिया नहीं देते, दैट्स द मेजॉरिटी पीपल, दे डोंट गिव एनेस्थीशिया, बट हियर इन आवर क्लिनिक वी फॉलो एनेस्थीशिया. सो दिस वी आर अप्लाइंग नंबिंग क्रीम एट द प्लेस वेयर आई एम गोइंग टू गिव रीजनल एनेस्थीशिया ब्लॉक. सो ये नंबिंग क्रीम लगा रहे, फिर इसी लाइन में लेटर ऑन आई विल गिव रीजनल ब्लॉक लिग्नोकेन प्लस एड्रेनालिन के. आई विल शो यू व्हेन आई एम गिविंग. Another way of giving anesthesia would be you can give a supratrochlear block here. Then someone who doesn't have any hair here, you can apply numbing cream, you can spray lignocaine. Those are other ways of giving anesthesia. Now this numbing cream will leave it for another 10-15 minutes till our GFC is ready, and then I will start giving local anesthesia there.
The numbing cream, it's been almost 20 minutes. Udena spirit wala. Clean the area. This is spirit. Spirit swab से we clean the area and now I'll start injecting the local anesthesia. Now this local anesthesia is lignocaine plus adrenaline, not plain lignocaine. It is less effective. So this is the vibrating device. You place the vibrator and start injecting. And it's not completely painless. Still hurts a little, but better than injecting without it. Also, when I'm injecting, I make sure that the skin is not too taut. Taut as in what tight nahi hai skin wahan ke. Because if it is too taut, if it's too tight, it hurts more. So ask the patient not to frown too much. बहुत ज़्यादा skin taut नहीं करना है. We leave this anesthesia for around 5 minutes so that the top of the head can be anesthetized. Take our gauze piece. So this numbing cream and this vibrating device, they basically make this process bearable. Again, I'm telling it's not completely painless. So this is done. So you see that I've injected along this line. From here, this is where I've injected. So with this, there will be anesthesia over this part. This area will be numb after about 5 minutes. But still यहाँ पे pain होगा and also back occipital area will still hurt. So while injecting we have to tell the patients कि this area will be fine but on the sides it can still hurt. We'll leave it for 5 minutes. So 10 minutes are up, GFC is ready. You should put ये knob पूरा zero पे लाकर then you have to switch it off. Press this button and open the lid. Now you can see GFC is ready, all four tubes. Now slowly you have to, now don't upar niche nahi karna tube ko, aram se iska cap khol ke and fill it in insulin syringes. Now GFC is easier to fill, kuch bahut dhyan nahi rakhna padta because niche gel rehta hai, so chances of making mistakes are very low. Filling PRP is slightly difficult, I'll teach that separately. Here GFC is very easy, just fill the liquid in insulin syringes. Typically if you are filling it properly then you should be able to fill about 7 to 8 syringes, 7 to 8 ml of GFC should be there if you make it properly. I've seen a lot of people wasting GFC, pura sab kuch process ke baad they end up with 4 syringes. That means you are not making the GFC properly. You open it like this. Now Dermaroller comes in different sizes. I typically use a 1 millimeter or a 1.5 millimeter Dermaroller. A lot of people use 0.5 millimeter Dermaroller. So yeah, you can use 0.5, 1, 1.5. आपके थोड़ा अभी भी डैंड्रफ है. हाँ, ऑलवेज टेल द पेशेंट इफ दे हैव डैंड्रफ और समथिंग. यू सी this all flakes because this dandruff itself will keep causing hair fall, so there should be zero dandruff. Treat the dandruff first, very very important. No amount of PRP GFC will be able to prevent dandruff wala hair fall. Once we are done with Dermaroller, we can start injecting. Now as you see, she has given me 7 ml of GFC. And I think there will be, yeah, there is a little more. She'll fill, give me that later. So what I'll do is I'll place 3 syringes here and 3 syringes here. This is so that I will know that I am injecting equally. So I'll go one here and then I can do 3 and 3 here. Just to make sure that equally distribute kar rahi hu main apna GFC. Now GFC should be injected at regular interval, but also don't inject too deep, like inject intradermally. In the deeper dermis is where it should be placed. There should not be any air in the GFC syringe, because if you have air in the GFC syringe you tend to waste more GFC, it keeps leaking. give special attention to this temporal area, because this is where they will be. Give special attention to this temporal area, because this is where there will be recession. A lot of patients are very much bothered about, inke itna nahi hai, but a lot of patients will be very much bothered about their receding line here. So, and when the baby hair starts coming in the temporal area, they are able to appreciate that very well. Gives them, you know, front aage se dekhne pe better coverage, better look. I tend to inject almost all of the PRP GFC. I don't waste the PRP GFC. Like a lot of people, what they do is ki agar 7 ml bana hai to usme se they inject 4 and then they 3 se massage or something like that. I feel like for massaging this little bit that is spilling over, that's enough. So I inject almost all of the GFC inside GFC or PRP. I feel like it gives better results. And you should be able to raise blebs. I don't know if it's visible on the camera or not, but if you are actually injecting in the deeper dermis, you should be able to see those blebs. Agar blebs nahi dikh rahe hain, to you are injecting too deep. If your blebs are too much visible, too light colored, that means you are in the superficial dermis. मतलब अगर बहुत ज़्यादा ब्लांचिंग है आपके ब्लेब्स में, तो यू आर इन द सुपरफिशियल डर्मिस. आइडियल डेप्थ इज द डीपर डर्मिस. दिस इज फॉर दिस साइड ना. या सो आई एम डन विद दिस साइड एंड नाउ आई विल रिपीट द प्रोसेस हियर. सो इफ यू एनेस्थेटाइज प्रॉपरली, दिस इज अ वेरी क्विक 5 minute थिंग. Again, it's not like it's completely painless, but much bearable. Patient will still feel the pain when I go towards the occiput and jab bahut side mein jaati hun tab. But most of the area it is painless. Always combine derma roller with PRP GFC. That improves the efficiency of PRP and GFC. There are many studies which have been done comparing only PRP whereas PRP plus derma roller, and all of the studies have indicated that adding derma roller increases the efficiency. It takes 5 minutes, but it's worth it. Now you see these little droplets, little bit of this PRP and GFC. Keep massaging that in. If you do that, then you don't need to waste PRP GFC separately. कोई एक सिरिंज वेस्ट करने की ज़रूरत नहीं है, इसमें हो जाता है. Also, if you see, I'm not carrying any gauze piece with me. Why? Because gauze में I don't want to waste this spillover in the gauze pieces. जो भी spillover है, I massage it in. जो हल्का सा एक ड्रॉप ब्लड भी आता है, मसाज इट इन रादर देन वाइपिंग इट ऑफ विद गॉस. इंजेक्टेड 7 ml ऑफ जीएफसी टिल नाउ. This is that little bit extra. Okay. So anywhere between 7 to 8 ml is a good amount of GFC. 4 ml is completely unacceptable. Now make sure that this is especially for doctors, after you are injecting your GFC, make sure that your therapist has used all the four tubes, they have filled all the four tubes, they don't leave anything in the tubes. So check that. Check after you inject your GFC ki isme kuch waste to nahi ho raha. Because sometimes it happens, some therapists they may be lazy, they may not fill that, you know, thoda thoda isme agar chhod diya to it's a waste. So अच्छे से पूरा यूज़ होना चाहिए. Now this is a low level laser light therapy. Now this is a optional kind of step. इसमें जो studies हैं वो उतने ज़्यादा ऐसा proof वो नहीं है whether this works or not is still controversial. But I feel कि अगर 2% 5% का भी कुछ इसमें improvement आ जाता है patient के लिए तो that's good. आँख बंद करिएगा. Ask the patients to close his eyes and then you can switch on the button. This is for 20 minutes. लेकिन अगर patient हरी में है, जल्दी है, कहीं जाना है, तो you can always skip this step. As I said, we don't know for sure whether this works or not. And even if it does, then to what extent. So derma roller is a must. 100% never skip derma roller. The right amount of GFC is a must. But this you can always skip.